It is not hard to understand why our next inductee got into education, considering his grandmother and his mother were teachers, and his father was a teacher who went on to become a principal in Orange County. Let's just say Joe Joyner grew up with high expectations to be a good student, and he was, attending Stonewall Jackson Junior High and then Colonial High School. Not only was he a good student, he was also a gifted athlete. He played junior varsity basketball and football, varsity track, and varsity football, where he was named the Metro Conference Outstanding Defensive Back and won the Colonial Outstanding Defensive Back Award his senior year. When I mentioned that Joe's father was a high school principal, he was actually Joe's principal at Colonial High School when he graduated in 1973. Colonial High played another important role in Joe's life because that's where he met his high school sweetheart, Susan Shanahan. Joe went to Florida State on a football scholarship. Susan went to the University of Georgia, but the long distance did not keep them apart. Obviously not. Joe and Susan married in 1976. They have been together ever since, 42 years. And they have two daughters, who are also teachers, by the way, and four grandchildren. After college, Joe and Susan moved to Prattville, Alabama, where they were both teachers, and Joe drove a school bus in the morning, taught during the day, and coached in the afternoon. But the lure of home and family pulled them back to Central Florida. In 1980, the Joyners returned to Central Florida, and Joe began teaching and coaching at Apopka High School, where after a few years, he became assistant principal. In 1989, he was named principal of Apopka High School, the youngest high school principal in OCPS history. Under his leadership, the school was designated a National School of Excellence by the U.S. Department of Education Blue Ribbon School Committee. Joe's dynamic leadership style didn't go unnoticed, and he spent the next 5 years at the district office leading secondary schools, and 5 years after that as area superintendent of the North Learning Community. And then after 23 years of dedicated service to OCPS, Joyner left to become superintendent of St. Johns County, where he spent the next 14 years with incredible success. For 8 years, St. Johns County was named the state's highest achieving district, graduation rates top 90% in the district, and the district earned an A grade from the state every year grades were given. In 2009, he was named Florida's Superintendent of the Year. In 2017, Dr. Joyner was named the new president of Flagler College in St. Augustine, where he has the opportunity to get back to his first love, more closely interacting with students, faculty, and staff.
He was always going to try to do the right thing, and he worked hard at it. He had great tenacity. His work ethic was unbelievable. That's what I noticed about him as a 10th grader.
It was just kind of a natural thing for him to move into administration, and he loved it. He really loved it because he could still do the athletics and be a part of the athletics and still go to the games. And what he really discovered was how much he loved being in different classrooms and seeing how kids learn and looking at different teacher techniques. That was what really inspired him.
Wherever he went, people just really enjoyed working for him and really, you know, respected the work that he did. He just had an uncanny way of making people feel heard and respected.
And he's really good at building a great team because he's a leader, but he doesn't act like a boss.
Dr. Joyner came to St. Johns County and he pushed us and moved us forward to being the top performing school district in the state.
He made you want to be a better leader. He taught me how to vocalize how much people meant to me.
Dr. Joyner, congratulations. This is a well-deserved honor for you, and all of St. John's County is appreciative of your work and your contribution to the lives of the children that live here.
Well, I don't know of anybody that deserves this honor more. You have influenced so many lives and done so many great things for people in Orange County and across the state.
It's kind of like a dad watching his kid grow up and become successful. That's the way I feel about him. He was like my son, and I think that he was one of those people that you know, you come along once in a lifetime.
I'm so very proud of Joe and all of his successes, and I'm thrilled to be a part of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Joseph Joyner.
Well, thank you very much, and I was told 2 to 3 minutes, and I'm going to stick to it. I'm the one who doesn't deserve to be here, honestly. I feel that way. But when I was told I was nominated by a teacher, Kathy Siriano, I said, okay. Because for me, it's always been about great teaching and in all the work that I've done. The real heroes in school, in education, and I'm sure Barbara Jenkins will agree to it, are teachers. My grandmother was a teacher, my mother was a teacher, my father was a teacher. Both my girls were teachers, all three of my brothers were teachers, and it's always been about great teaching. And really, you know, my mom and dad put us in the car from West Tennessee in 1960 with the windows down, no seat belts, both of them smoking cigarettes. And we drove from West Tennessee to Orlando because the teaching salaries in Orlando were so high. And my father got a job at Howard Junior High teaching U.S. history, and back then he used to be able to take us to class, and he would take me to class while he taught U.S. history, and you would stand up and say the Pledge of Allegiance and the Lord's Prayer before class started. I remember that. And he became dean at Howard Junior High, and after that he became principal at Durance Elementary for a couple of years. And then he was sent to Ocoee Junior Senior High to integrate Orange County Public Schools. Think about that. And so I watched my dad go through that. And after he went through that, I remember him throwing rocks at him, going into his job. And I watched that, and I watched leadership, and I watched an integrity. And it meant so much to me. My dad died about 3 years ago, and he would be so proud to be here tonight because he's a real hero for Orange County Public Schools. Then he got sent to Colonial, and strangely enough, he was my principal, which was kind of a different sort of experience for me at that time. But he really was my hero, but I just want to thank him. You know, I wouldn't be where I would be. You know, I met my wife, she went to Howard, and I went to Stonewall Jackson, and I saw her coming out of a house one time, and I said, I have no chance. She's at Howard, I'm at Stonewall Jackson Junior High, and we fell in love, and been married for 42 years, and I can't thank her and my daughters enough for, I would not be where I am without my wife Susan and her help. Finally, I want to thank the leaders, and Jim Schott gave me a chance. I was 20-something, a coach at Apopka High School, and he gave me a chance to be an administrator. And Larry Payne was a principal who gave me a chance. Don Shaw gave me a chance to be a principal. I watched all those people, and I wanted to be like them. And I wanted to be like my dad, and I can't thank them enough for what they've done. Finally, I just want to say a big thank you to the folks who drove over from St. Augustine, Frank Upchurch, David Drisdale, and also Mitch Walk, who are trustees, and I thank you for your trust in me and what you've done. Orange County Public Schools created the foundation in my leadership. My heart is here, and it created what I am as a servant leader. And I thank you, and I thank God for the experience that I've had here. Thank you.